Welcome back. You're watching Money, Money, Money. This week, we are teaching you how to get tax smart. Use certain efficient ways in which you can minimize your tax hit in certain specific cases. Now, we just spoke about buying and selling shares and how you can be tax efficient and tax smart there. Now, let's talk about basically investments in liquid assets or in fixed income assets, which anyway don't fetch us too much return these days. So it's quite a harrowing experience, as we know. Now, the second case study, Mr. Roongta, that you've given us is Mr. Rahul Bedi. He's a 35-year-old individual. He's a high-income earner, and he falls in the highest tax bracket as his income is 50 lakhs. He wants to keep aside 10 lakh of those rupees in a contingency fund, basically an emergency fund of sorts, where he can simply access the money instantly in case there is any sort of a financial hit. He says the investment should be reasonably liquid and maybe also offer decent post-tax returns. What are the suggestions? Question on everyone's mind, Mr. Roongta.
I think the standard thing that people do is put it in liquid funds and ultra short-term funds, which will give you or at least returns equivalent to an FD without the TDS or other hassles.
But the point is that, you know, the argument that fixed income funds, liquid funds are far more tax efficient, that only holds true if you're going to hold on for 3 years, because that's when you get the indexation benefit, right? That's when the post-tax return looks much better than an FD.
So you're partially right there. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the return, the higher return kicks in after 3 years. Mm-hmm. But even during the first 3 years, the two big advantages that the liquid fund and ultra short term fund have is there is no TDS, right? So you are able to plan your, suppose you had 50 lakhs, out of which say only 20 lakhs was going to remain for 3 years. Mm. Balance 30 lakhs you needed, within the 3 years. But you didn't know how much exactly you would need. Mm. By putting the entire thing on 50 lakhs, you have the advantage that if you don't need that 30 lakhs, you are really accruing a higher post-tax return. Mm. So there is an advantage to liquid and ultra short-term fund. But one of the things which people are doing is looking at arbitrage funds. Mm-hmm. Now, this is something that a lot of high net worth individuals do who pay high taxes, simply because arbitrage funds, although they completely mimic the returns of a liquid fund.
Mm. They're treated like an equity
fund. They're treated like an equity fund. And I think the option that they typically choose is a dividend reinvestment option.
Okay.
So the dividend that an arbitrage fund earns during the month declares it off as a dividend, right? Mm. And the dividend is completely tax-free, both in the hands of the fund and in the hands of the receiver. Mm-hmm. And because it is reinvested, it earns next month, right? So because of that dividend reinvestment, the NAV remains more or less constant. At the end of the month, it equalizes back to the standard NAV.
Okay.
So at any given point, if you want to sell, you're unlikely to make any short-term capital gain.
Okay.
And whatever returns you've got them by way of dividend.
Okay.
And so that becomes completely tax-free.
Okay.
Just to give you an example, I mean, this changes every day, as we know, but liquid funds, if they were giving you around 6.5%, dividend reinvestment arbitrage fund would typically give you around 5.5%.
Okay.
These are regular plans. If you do direct, proportionately, would get higher in both.
Mm.
So the advantage of arbitrage is for high taxpayers that 5 to 5.5 is much better than the 6 to 6.5, especially if you are going to keep that money for, as you said, less than 3 years.
Okay.
The only disadvantage, the reason people might have detractors for this kind of a strategy, one, in an arbitrage fund, typically takes you 3 days to get your money.
Okay.
Versus a liquid fund, which is a day, and now up to 50,000 rupees is instant, or 10 minutes. It's not really instant, 5 or 10 minutes. But it is that liquid. Mm-hmm. Whereas arbitrage is 3 days. Then there is a certain section which feels that the arbitrage opportunities in the market might dry up and therefore the rate may fall. Mm. My view to that is, but you can get out of this anytime.
Mm.
Typically, there is a exit load in the first 15 or 30 days. After that, you can get out anytime. So if the opportunity in the markets dry up, get out of the arbitrage and put it in liquid.
Okay, but you're saying that the return of a liquid fund typically would be around 6-6.5. And that for an arbitrage fund would be 5-5.5.
Correct.
So it's only...
But post-tax it makes sense.
Okay.
Because it's 6-6.5 minus the tax.
Yeah.
You would effectively end up making about 4-4.5%.
And here it's not even going to cost me short term, as you explained, because the NAV is pretty much remaining constant.
Correct.
Okay, fair enough. So now that's one way of being a little smart about, you know, how to invest in, you know, securities which are primarily liquid or rather fixed income in nature. Any other way of ensuring that I'm not, you know, wasting my money, letting it lie in an FD, then paying a huge amount of tax on it? Any other manner?
So a lot of your viewers are going to have home loans.
Hmm.
I would urge all of them to consider these linked account, these are called offset loans,
okay,
where a savings account or a current account is linked to your home loan or to your education loan or to your loan against property. It applies across all kinds of loans. The balance lying in these regular savings or current accounts, that is treated as a prepayment.
Right.
And you pay interest on your home loan or education loan only to the extent of balance in the loan minus the balance in the account.
Right.
But in the account itself is a, like a regular account. You can withdraw, you can pay by net, you can use debit cards. So it's completely liquid. What it ends up doing is it allows you to save interest on your loan.
On the loan, whether it's a home loan or any other
loan. Or any other loan.
Okay.
So if it's a home loan and let's say you're paying 8.5%. And if you're getting a tax deduction for it, then effective cost to that is 5.5%, let's say.
Okay.
Right? Then whatever money you keep in this linked account is saving you 5.5%.
Okay.
Completely liquid. Please remember, this is like any other account. It's completely liquid.
Okay.
Right? On the other hand, like most people, if your loans, if it's a home loan and if it is about 20, 25 lakhs, then it's not deductible any longer. The interest is not deductible any longer. So you're, if you're paying 8.5%, that's your post-tax cost as well. In which case, the money you keep in the savings account or the linked savings account or linked current account is being saving you interest at 8.5% and instantly available.
Okay.
So it's an ideal vehicle to keep your contingency fund.
All right, those are some smart ways of saving more, earning more, and also being more tax efficient. We'll take another quick break. On the other side, why it might be a better idea to gift mutual fund units to your children in case you're saving money for your children, their higher education, instead of redeeming those units and then passing on the money to the kids. We'll talk about that when we come back.